GIF.
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 You know what I'm talking about, right? Those little animated videos that you can drop in private messages or on social media like Facebook and Twitter to reply to people's posts? The GIF, or graphic interchange format, is the second most widely used form of image on the entire internet after the JPEG. Well, how would you like to learn how to make your own in Filmora? Stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
You can make a GIF out of almost any piece of footage. The only things you need to keep in mind is that these will be read by whatever platform they're viewed on as a series of images, so there won't be any sound. Any message you want to convey will have to be done with just words and images alone. Bring your footage down into your timeline and clip out a short section that you want to use. Like I said, you won't be using any of the audio, so you can just mute that by right-clicking on the footage. Add any text that you might want to put into your GIF by clicking on the titles feature and bringing that down into your timeline. Many of you already know that clicking on your text track allows you to access the text features to change the color, the font, and the size of your text. You can move the position of your text by clicking on it in the preview window. Try not to get too busy with the amount of text, because these will end up being small and usually hard to read. Keep your GIF simple. These can be great assets to help you build your brand awareness, increase recognition, or just personalize any conversation that allows you to upload a GIF. Once you have your elements in place, click on Export, and then in the format type on the left, click GIF. You can change these settings to improve the resolution, frame rate, and bit rate so that your GIFs will be more crisp and play smoothly. But keep in mind that Facebook Messenger, Twitter, and other social media applications have different limits on how large these files can be. So keep your total file size at 5 megabytes or under so that they'll work in most applications. Now, Filmora is going to tell you the file size here, but don't believe it. The truth is, it exports at a larger size than listed here. So once you've finished your export, click on Find Target, and then right-click on the footage to see the properties, and you'll be able to determine the actual size of your GIF file. If it's too big or over 5 megabytes, either change the export settings or trim your footage down a bit. Once you're done and it's 5 megabytes or under, they are ready to share. But be careful, you might get in a GIF war with a GIF master, so wield your new power wisely.
And that's how you make your own GIF... GIF... peace.